There it is! That's the sign!
Right, I'm getting straight to the pitch. The new petition is at mathballs.com. Please do go there, link below, and sign the petition. We want to get a Wembley Stadium's worth of signatures. However, if you're one of these people who insists on knowing the details of what you're signing, fine, here's the video. I have a plan to fix this geometric abomination. It's a new plan. So if you've been watching my channel for a while, you know I have a long-running campaign against the geometrically inaccurate football on a UK street sign, because that's made of light-coloured hexagons and dark-coloured hexagons, whereas an actual classic football is made of light-coloured hexagons, so far so good, and dark-coloured pentagons. And I cannot overstate this. A pentagon has five sides, and a hexagon has six sides. I've said that sentence so many times. I went on Sport TV. I did a lot of sport media, which I wasn't used to. And this all happened 6 years ago when I launched a campaign to fix the street signs because they are a national embarrassment. This is the biggest problem facing society in the UK. And I had a parliamentary petition because this is Department for Transport. They mandate these signs. They could change. And I didn't ask to fix the old ones. I just said update the design, make it accurate for all future street signs. And if I got over 10,000 signatures, I would get a letter from the government saying what they were going to do. And I have an update. Please do sign the petition. We have such a fantastic community of people who watch mathematics videos on YouTube. Let's put that to good use. Together, we can change society for the better.
Past Matt, so young and naive, also so hairy.
And I did get a letter from the government, and it turns out they said, no. They said they're not going to fix the street signs. And I won't read the whole thing out. It's deeply underwhelming. They don't really address any of my major points about how the geometry is wrong and how that's sending the wrong signals in a country that claims to care about mathematical education. But I will say one thing here. The purpose of a traffic sign is not to raise public appreciation and awareness of geometry, which is better dealt with in other ways. So that was the whole argument. And they both say that the detail, like in a fixed sign, would be too subtle for drivers to notice. And they say that the correct geometry would be, and I quote, so distracting, it would increase the risk of an accident. Come on. So I was very upset by that. And I felt like they didn't take me seriously. I was like, if only I could have some kind of insight into what their decision-making process was when they gave me that letter. But the only way we could do that would be with a Freedom of Information request to get all the internal emails that pertain. We did exactly that. A journalist friend of mine got all the personal information's redacted. We got all the internal communications that pertain to the response I got. And the consensus is they said no. And it's not an interesting no. There's absolutely no discussion about if my case had any merits. They're just like, how do we tell this guy to go away? And I'll quote one bit from it. The government considers the current football symbol conveys a clear meaning understood by the public. Changing the design for public appreciation of geometry is not the purpose of a traffic sign. I would argue that being geometrically plausible is the purpose of a street sign. And that's kind of where we're at. If you've seen my Humble Pie stand-up special or read the book, both of which are out as we speak, I go into a bit more detail about the response I got from the government. And I go through yet again why this sign is so offensive. Now, a lot of people during the campaign did say, hey, Matt, have you considered maybe the street signs are just a different football?
There are football that is made of hexagons. It's not the classic one you think it is. Well, the problem is, we can prove, mathematically, you cannot make a ball entirely out of hexagons. We don't know how many hexagons. We don't know how they were arranged. But we do know for a fact that if you take n, subtract 3n, add on 2n, you get an answer of 0. You cannot get 2. It's absolutely impossible. So there's no way you can have a ball where you get a value of 2. The only exception is you get a value of 0 on a ball if you punch a hole through it. So we've both closed the door on having an all-hexagon foot ball, but we've opened the option of an all-hexagon foot donut. What would that look like, though? I made one. Yeah.
Thanks to the Kickstarters who made filming Humble Pie, a comedy of maths errors, possible. It and my new book, Love Triangle, the life-changing magic of trigonometry, are both available to purchase. Well, you can pre-order Love Triangle, please do. It's on massgear.co.uk, and they have more details about my ridiculous ongoing campaign.
And so the conclusion to the saga up until now has been, if I can't get a ball out of hexagons, we're going to make a foot donut out of hexagons. And we had a video game where you try and bounce a foot donut across the field. And then that was my attempt to kind of bring this whole saga to a close. But then I had another revelation. While it's impossible to make a ball entirely out of hexagons, it is possible to make a ball partly out of hexagons. Like, you could have hexagons just in one area and other shapes somewhere else. And so I realized it would be technically possible to make a football such that from one specific angle, it looks like the sign, which means I've got a whole new avenue to take this campaign. Instead of trying to get the signs changed to match the football, I could get the football changed to match the signs. But to make a football that looks like that from only one angle, I'll need to find someone who can make custom footballs.
So I found someone who makes custom footballs.
John Paul makes custom and often highly geometric footballs. You may have seen some of their work online. I'm a huge fan of what they do. I particularly like the hat tile football they made a while ago, but they've done loads of other ridiculous balls. It was an honor to be able to drop by and visit John Paul and their partner Allison and see how they make these incredible footballs. And a while ago, John Paul got in touch and said, do you want to collaborate on a ball? And I said, oh my goodness, I need a football that looks like the street signs. And they got to work. They used 3D software to try and figure out how all the shapes could go together. And then they got stitching. They initially made a prototype, but then they made the real deal. And I was able to go there for the grand unveiling.
This is it. I'm so excited. But I'm curious to know how did you make the impossible? Like, this shouldn't exist.
I've got props.
Okay, yeah.
So this is a prototype.
Early version.
A rejected prototype that we use as a stepping stone. Yeah.
Oh, that's really
so
great. Yeah.
The basic kind of process was starting with just a standard ball.
Yep.
In 3D software, orientating it like in one specific direction, and then it was literally just a case of having the logo up as a reference and adjusting
and
the line.
Messing around with it
to sort of create this, like, you know, these warped panels. But it just so happens that, yeah, it's two angles on the ball. It looks like it's constructed from just hexagons.
And then just a nightmare.
Yeah, just don't look at this.
yeah.
So the next version kind of, you know, tried to sort of blend these panels together a little bit. So combine this one.
Got it.
Basically made it less than like a half and half.
And meld them together, which is what we have here.
Exactly. So forget about that. So it's gone. Do you want to do the honors?
I do. Okay. We have... hang on. Okay, I don't want to drop it in the process of unveiling it. That's so good. It hasn't got the same equator. That's very disconcerting viewed from that angle. But there it is. That's the sign.
That's the sign, yeah.
So how does the impossible ball, the impossible, actually work? Well, John Paul was constrained by the street sign. Those hexagons have to be where those hexagons are. So it looks like the sign, which means it looks nothing like an actual football. It's got much smaller panels and seemingly more of them, because that's what we had to do to make it look like the sign. So it's not going to have your 20 hexagons and your 12 pentagons of a classic football. It's going to have, I don't know, are those white ones, they're going to be 20 hexagons still? Maybe more? Are there 12 more hexagons where the pentagons should be? Well, you know what? Let's count them. So, in terms of the number of hexagons, We know we have those seven on the front. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on the front. We were constrained by the sign. They're clearly hexagons. We can see all of them. They have to be on the ball. But the ones around the edge, well, they're a bit more ambiguous. So we can use those to hide the curvature we need to make this a ball, which you cannot do just using hexagons. But we'll keep counting hexagons for now. So around the side, let's have a look. One on the bottom there, that's hexagon number 8. Up the top there's number 9. And if we roll right up to the top, we've also got 10, 11, 12, 13. They're all quite classic regular hexagons. Those two middle ones are like non-regular hexagons, 14 and 15. They're kind of squashed down. But that's all the hexagons. Oh, we're only counting half the ball. It is symmetric a bit, so I'm counting half of it, and we'll double them at the end. In terms of other shapes, you can see some pentagons now. So there's one pentagon's at the top, two there. We roll back down. You may have seen a bunch earlier on. There's one there, 3. Not a regular pentagon. Still a pentagon. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And of course, twice as many because we have the other side as well. And that's it, apart from the octagon. That weird panel in the middle. Count them up. 8 edges. That's an octagon. So that's the whole ball. Well, half of it. If we double them, that's the whole ball. 30 hexagons, 16 pentagons, 2 octagons, way more panels. 1.5 times as many as the classic football. And it's because we had to have only hexagons on the front, but now we have a big curvature debt. Hence, the chaos, the absolute ridiculousness around the side. This is a much more mathematically complicated ball. It looks far less regular than the classic one, but very importantly, it does look like the signs. Just don't look at it from the side.
Now that we have the ball, all we have to do is convince the English Premier League that this is what they should be using. Liverpool Football Club, I mean, come on. For the American viewers, Liverpool is like one of the top soccer teams in the world. And here in the UK, they're a staple of the Premier League. That's the top league. I mean, they won the whole thing in the 2019 season. You do not get more English football than Liverpool. So I got in touch and I explained the idea. I wanted to get this new ball involved. And they're like, that's incredible. Come on in. We'll get some players who can have a look at it. We've got, and I'm like, whoa, well, hang on. Well, I don't want the football players. I want the football analytics team. I want your maths nerds. And they're like, well, yeah, sure. You can come and see them. So we're here. We're going to see if this football would work in an actual game. Can I get your thoughts? Now, I did send you pictures of this before. Let me get the right way up.
Yeah.
Ah?
Yeah. I mean, I honestly don't know what to say. when I first saw this, it made me feel a little bit ill.
Your first words were, that makes me feel ill. That's...
So yeah, I mean, I'm very sensitive to 3D geometry, and yeah, I was fully behind your campaign to get the signs changed. I was one of the
signatures petition, yeah.
on the petition, but yeah, sadly, didn't work out. But yeah, this, I mean, it's a work of art, but also it brings me nightmares. So.
That's a very polite way to put it. It's a work of art. Another fun fact: Tim is the person who designed the foot donut. So the foot donut game was your doing.
Yes, for my sins. That was one of my pieces of work. I had a lot of fun putting that together.
And I bet you did.
Yeah,
I just tweeted a photo of a foot donut and you went and coded up a game.
Yes, I originally met Tim through the foot donut, and we've worked together on a few projects since, none of them pertaining to his day job. So it was nice I got to visit him at Liverpool and talk about his statistical work and how their team gets so much data from so many different games all around the world.
Every time the football is touched within a game, we get coordinates on the pitch, the player who makes that touch, and the context around it. And we get that all through the game for many tens of thousands of games from all across the world.
Oh, so it's not just the Premier League, you're getting everything.
No, it's leagues all the way down to League One in the UK, through to South American leagues, China, North America, all across Europe. Basically any league that you can think of, we've probably got data for it.
Why do you need data from so many different games? What are you trying to do here?
Well, basically our primary role in the research department is recruitment. So we're trying to see who the next best player is going to be, who we would want to sign for Liverpool, so that we can obviously get the best result we can in the league. And in order to do that, we need to look at games across the whole world so that we can find all of those mysterious players that nobody else has spotted yet.
Your data scouts.
Effectively, yeah. We work very closely with the scouting department because obviously they've got their perspective and we can bring a sort of slightly different perspective from the point of view of statistics and data. And those two things combined can be really powerful, and in combination that helps us make much better decisions when it comes to transferring players in and out of the club.
And I should say, Tim has a new YouTube channel, Tim and Kat's Green Walk, which is all about solar panels,
heat pumps,
energy around the house.
Yep, all that stuff. Yep.
Yeah, I'll link to it below. Check it out.
Of course, we showed the ball to the rest of the research team. We took it to their office and they had a bit of an impromptu kick around. Everyone thought it was a little bit trippy watching how the ball changes, how it looks as it rotates. But as you can see, definitely works as an actual football. And while they all had their thoughts, we thought we'd go right to the top and speak to the head of the whole research division.
And I'm just wondering, what are your thoughts so far on this as a football?
Well, like a lot of our models, from one angle, right, it works perfectly.
I feel like I'm getting a lot of very carefully worded half insults when Tim described it as art. Not in a good way.
I would say it's art in a good way.
Okay, oh, good. That's it. You know,
art is all about perspective.
Thank you.
Yes.
And my perspective is it's a perfectly valid ball.
I agree.
Well, I mean, as always, the proof is on the pitch.
Yes.
So we're going to take this ball and we're going to actually kick it around. Oh. They're able to find me a spare Liverpool kit to wear for the kick around, but the closest they could get to my initials was DP, which stands for Dad Parker.
It was such a special moment kicking around the Impossi ball on the Liverpool Football Club Premier League indoor warm-up pitch. But the big question was, of course, would the Premier League players accept this as a new game ball? And I asked the researchers, they said there's no way the players would ever accept this as a game ball. They kick the ball so hard and so fast, the aerodynamics make a big difference. You can bend the direction the ball is going in, and this ball is not even, it's not symmetric enough. As it's rotating, it's got different axes of rotation, and the way you spin it would change how it bends in the air, which I think would add a new element to the game. Apparently, no, they don't accept that. It also looks weird. As it rotates, it looks different, and apparently that would make it very difficult to play with, which I can confirm, obviously, pretty good at football, and the only way you can explain this is because of the confusing appearance of the ball.
So there you are, it's a perfectly legitimate ball. You can use it for a quick kick around. Premier League players may be a little upset, but I think it's gonna add even more randomness to the game and opportunity to exploit the mildly asymmetric nature of the ball. So I think we're still a go. I think we still change the ball to match the signs. I'm not gonna send you to one of those petition sites that harvest your data. I'm gonna send you to my petition site that will harvest your data. So if you go to massballs.com, you can sign up for the petition.
And here's what I'm hoping. If enough people sign a petition for the Premier League to change to a ball, which the players hate, but it's the only way to make the signs make sense, we now have the Premier League wanting the government to change the signs as well. Because as we established, there's not enough political will at the moment to change the signs. But if the Premier League are like, look, people really care about this, and we don't want to have to use Matt's ridiculous, mathematically complicated football, the only way out of this is for the government to fix the signs. So, for that to happen, we need you and tens of thousands of other people, please tell all your friends, to say yes to mathematically complicated footballs.
I think if we get more than, what's Wembley Stadium, like 90,000 people? If we get more than a Wembley of names signed up, there'll be a counter on the website, massballs.com, then I will take the names to the Premier League, see if we can get this done. And if anyone knows anyone in the government, in the Department for Transport, come on, surely we can still get those signs changed. Huge thanks to John Paul, check out Tour Pentagons on TikTok. Thanks to Tim, check out there. His channel on YouTube, linked below. And thanks to everyone here at Liverpool who let us come in, have a kick around, talk about some data analytics and this fantastic asymmetric ball.